Time of Masa. Masa, you do this. You will go to Masa time, you will do that. No. You get your fingers and see, amazing. Fard is quarter. The head is divided into four parts. Top, back, two. One, two, three, four. Four. Now you get your hand together like this. You do this. You see the hand has four parts. One, two, three, four. Yeah? Amazing. Hikmat and Sunnat of Rasulullah. These three fingers will go over the head. Like this. These two palms will do silence. That is three quarters done. And the back of the head you will do with the back of your arm like this on your neck as well. Everything is done. Two things are left for. Ears. Now what do you do with ears? This finger that you use now as this thumb. You put the finger inside your ears and you put the thumb behind your ears. Hand has been used, head masa has been done. Sunnat is done, fard is done. Allah Ta'ala is razi, Rasulullah is razi as Allah. Allahu Akbar. And then at the end, what do you do? You wash your feet. What do we find people do today? They will not wear, they will have thin socks on and they will wipe over them. They will be wearing shoes and they will wipe over them. Huh? You're leaving Sunnat of Rasulullah is razi. You are so busy, you can't take your shoes off and wash your feet. And with every amal, there is a dua as well. When you wash your hands, there's a dua. There are duas, mustahab duas to read in these times as well. When he washes his feet, he does khilal of the fingers of his feet, khilal of his, I forgot to miss khilal, you do khilal of your fingers here, and if you've got a beard, you do khilal, like this. You push it up, the khilal, making sure the beard is wet. And then he does khilal of his foot, including his ankle. That is his wudu done. That is his wudu done. Nabi Ali Salam said, taharat is the shirt of ibadat. If taharat isn't there, what ibadat is there? What ibadat is there? If you don't know how to do wudu properly. لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ مِفْتَاح. For everything there's a key. وَمِفْتَاحُ صَلَاةَ الْوُدُو. The key of prayer is wudu. And مِفْتَاحُ الْجَنَّةِ is what? As-salah. And the key to Jannat is Namaz. And if you want to get to Jannat, you need Namaz. And if you want to get the key of Namaz, you need to have Wudu. And if you need the key of Wudu, you need to have Niyat. And if you want the key of Niyat, you need to have a good heart. If you don't have any of these, what Namaz is there? This is why it's important that we learn these Masail which are important. We give so much emphasis, 15 Night Shaban, Laylatul Mawlid, this. Very good, Alhamdulillah. But if you don't know how to do wudu properly, what ibadat in that night will Allah accept? Final waqia I will finish with. I know time is of the essence. People like me don't need 30 minutes, it's never enough. Shaitan came to an old man. Shaitan said to his mu'ideen, he said, listen, I'm going to tell you the difference between ilm and just ibadat, just knowledge. Knowledge and just bas, praise Allah, Allah, kari jau, kari jau. Just that and ill. So what is it? Shaitan disguised himself in the form of an old man. He took his friends with him, his muridin, chale, whatever you want to call them. Took them. Old man was in masjid. Baba was reading namaz, Allah, but he says in namaz, subhanallah, subhanallah, tasbih, all that. And Shaitan goes, Baba ji, hey. He said, ji, what is it? Can I have one more? He said, what is it? He said, I've got a question for you. My question is, can Allah Ta'ala put the entire dunya through the eye of a needle? You know needle? Suri? Through this. Or an egg. Can Allah Ta'ala put the entire dunya, all this world, into an anda, an egg? He says, what kind of question? Look how big dunya, look how small egg. Not possible. The south. Baba ji, you see namaz up there, you know. What is your? You're smiling. You do your ibadat. You carry it. He carries your ibadat. He says, now we go to an alim. They go to Hazrat Sahib's house, knock on the door. Hazrat Sahib is sleeping. He's doing tahajjat and ibadat. Hazrat Sahib is sleeping. They are sleeping. Jiyan. says, you're disturbing me, I'm sleeping. What's wrong with you? He says, Sadiq Swal, what is your question? He said, my question is, can Allah Ta'ala put the entire dunya, world, everything into an egg? Or through the head of a needle? He says, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. She goes, what can't Allah do? He's Qadir Mutlaq. He's inna Allah ala kulli shay'in qadir. He can do everything. If Allah Ta'ala wanted, he could do that. So Hazrat Sahib, you go back to sleep. You sleeping is better for me. Because if he was awake, he will tell the people what's right and wrong. So you go back to sleep. He goes back to sleep. He calls his chelel and says, come here. I ask the same question to an armed abid, worshipper. He didn't know the answer. He committed kufr. Yani he limited Allah Ta'ala. He said, Allah Ta'ala has no power. What use is his ibadah? He can read all night. If he doesn't have ilm, there is no faydah in that ibadah. Without ilm, the asr haqeeqat, maqsad of ibadah is you worship Allah with knowledge. That alim was asleep. I asked him one question, with one answer, he took me away. One answer, he gave me everything. That's why Nabi Islam said, one scholar, one learned individual is more difficult for shaitan than 1,000 people to misguide. He misguided thousands of people. He said, chalo jao ibadat karo pura shaban ki, lekin all of the nights, make sure you're out chilling. That's how shaitan thinks. But when it comes to the ulama, when it comes to men of knowledge, scholars, imams, khutaba, khatib, these people who have ilm, shaitan is attacking them and saying, no, don't go to the masjid. Tell me, makao. This is why, Hazrat, it's important. This is a very blessed night. A night that we open our eyes. We do tawbah on this night. Tubu ila Allah ayyuhal mu'minun. Do tawbah to Allah, believe. Allah Ta'ala will forgive everything. There are many young people who ask me, I've done too many sins, fornicated, adultery, I've done everything, drinking, gambling. Allah Ta'ala won't forgive me. Hazrat, Allah will forgive everything. Exception. Unless you do tawbah. إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله بما يوسف الله رحمة الله will forgive you. Allah Ta'ala will forgive you. But you've got to go and ask for forgiveness. And if you can't cry, you act like you're crying. Allah Ta'ala says, Habib al-Islam says, even if you act like you're crying, Allah Ta'ala's rahmat will go into Josh and say, forgive him. Forgive him because he wants to be forgiven. This is the night to ask Allah's forgiveness. Ask Allah Ta'ala, Ya Allah, forgive me for my saghira and kabira guna. Oh Allah, give me tawfiq to do ibadah. Oh Allah, the last year of sin that I've done wrong, the coming year, let me do more good deeds. Oh Allah, let me change tonight and become a better person. I make dua that Allah Ta'ala gives us all tawfiq to act upon what I've said.
Amen.
Wa kulu qawli hadha astaghfirullah.